Thank you so much, Phyllis. The whole world is in his hands. All right, we are going to start this morning by remembering that if we want to see the light, if we want to see the love, we first must be the love.
You've got to be the light if you want to see the light. You've got to be the light if you want to see the light. Because you reap what you sow, you meet what you know, and you see what you believe. Give a little bit of that good thing if you want to receive. You've got to be the love if you want to see the love. You've got to be the love if you want to see the love. Because you reap what you sow, you meet what you know, and you see what you believe. Give a little bit of that good thing if you want to receive. Don't tell me that your life is a desert. Somebody gotta quench your thirst. You can dance, you can pray for the water. Because you reap what you sow, you meet what you know, and you see what you believe. Give a little bit of that good thing if you want to receive. You've got to be the love if you want to see the love. You've got to be the love if you want to see the love. Because you reap what you sow, you meet what you know, and you see what you believe. Give a little bit of that good thing if you want to receive.
All right. I don't know if you noticed, but it is a beautiful day out there. Not only is it a beautiful day within our consciousness, but Mother Nature is showing her beauty this morning to us.
Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful day. This beautiful day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing day. This healing day. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends.
Yeah.
Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful friends.
That's right.
My wonderful friends. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day.
Oh.
Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This beautiful day. This beautiful day.
That's right.
This beautiful day. This beautiful day.
This next song is a request from Betsy's Aunt Karen. Is that right?
Yes.
Betsy's Aunt Karen said, I missed that song you were singing earlier this month called I Claim a Blessing. So here we go.
Ooh, ah, ooh, ah. In the morning when I get out of bed, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Before I even lift my head, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Before I even lift my head, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Well, I claim a blessing. I wonder what good will come to me. Ooh, I claim a blessing. I claim it. Ooh, I claim a blessing. Well, I claim it. Ooh, I claim a blessing.
Good morning, everyone. Let's join in affirming our statement of being together. There is only one presence and one power in the universe, God the good, omnipotent. This power expresses life, love, wisdom, and abundance through me. In it, I live and move and have my being. Good morning, my name is Dan Pikarski, and I will be your service leader today. So welcome, and I want to welcome all of you who may be joining us for the first time on our live stream, and thank you for being here, and all of our regular watchers, thank you again to joining us today. If you'd like to find out a bit more about us, or to receive our newsletter, we invite you to visit our website at unityofbloomington.org. It's all run together, unityofbloomington.org. And you can subscribe to our newsletter directly there. Now at Unity, we offer practical spiritual teachings that empower abundant and meaningful living. And we believe and practice the following. God is absolute good everywhere present. God is. We have a spark of divinity with us, the Christ spirit within. Our very essence is of God, and therefore we are also inherently good. I am. We create our experience of life by the activity of our thinking. Everything in the manifest realm has its beginning in thought. I create. Prayer is creative thinking that heightens the connection with God mind and therefore brings forth wisdom, wholeness, prosperity, and everything good. I pray. And through thought, words, and action, we live the truth we know. I live. I now want to invite Ginger up to give us a moment with the children.
Hello, hello, hello.
Is this a good spot for me? I have my elephant mask on today. I hope everyone can see it. If not, next time we see each other, I will show you my elephant mask. So, good morning, everyone. I have my nice little handy wipe here that I'm wiping my mic. When I give this mic to Phyllis, we're gonna wipe it again. We're practicing our safe gathering right now. How have you been doing? I miss seeing your beautiful faces in person. And I'm so happy that some of you have been posting some of your activities that you've been doing that we've been sending, that Unity of Blooming has been sending out to you. I know a couple of weeks ago we sent out, and I don't know if you can see this, so if Seb needs to focus unless he can, we sent out these little circles, these little ovals, and you could take a pen or a little scratchy device and you could reveal what was underneath it. And some of you posted those on our YFM Facebook page. And this is my personal one that I did. I wrote, "Love is the answer." And I crossed out a bunch of hearts that came through, and they're all very beautiful and colorful. So if you would like, I know that the Smithson family, they posted some of their artwork on the Facebook page. And if you would like to post yours, just ask the big people in your house to take a photo of it and upload it to Facebook. Last week, Reverend Lynette did a science experiment. I was pretty impressed, a little jealous maybe. We'll have to talk about this a little later. I found out that I was very competitive. And so I was like, wow, I would love to do something great like that. But what I did instead was Ms. Zara, in our last email that we sent out to you, she gave us another experiment to do at home. And it was so fascinating to me that I got with my big person, my husband, Scott, and we got together and we did the little experiment. It's an experiment with density. And make sure you ask your big person in your house what that means, because I'm not gonna do a good job of explaining it. But it was really cool. So Seb, can you put or go to the next PowerPoint? I guess that's safe to. This is what my husband and I created. You can see the bottom is red, and that's with corn syrup. And the blue is dishwashing detergent. Green in there is actually just water. And then the light green, it's supposed to be yellow, but it didn't turn out yellow. But the light green is actually oil. And so the densities of each of these liquids has it staying in place and creating such a beautiful kind of rainbow of colors. And one of the things that I noticed when I was, you know, looking at this, actually I brought my jar here with me today, but on the car ride over, it dumped over a couple times and it got all mixed up. So I'm really glad I took a picture because, it doesn't travel well. But my husband suggested that we take a flashlight and place it behind our colorful experiment with density, and this is what happens. What you're seeing on the screen here is that the colors got brighter, and I could see the differentiation of the colors. And so I think about that, and I think that's what you and I can do, is if we make sure that we're shining our light, then it makes our diversity, our beauty, our love shine that much brighter. Because you and I might be the only love that another person might see. So remember that as you go through the week, as you're with your brother, your sister, your mom, or your dad, or if you get to have a distance play date with someone, we're practicing letting our light shine and being love to those we come in contact with. So we're going to sing a wonderful blessing song to you, and it's called the Unity Blessing.
We love you. We bless you. We truly, truly appreciate you. And we behold the Christ in you.
Thank you, Ginger. That was awesome. What a cool experiment. It turned out beautiful. Maybe it will separate later and we can all look at it. This month, we continue Unity's 2020 theme, Perfect Vision, Seeing Through a Spiritual Lens, with our May focus, Curiosity. Curiosity unlocks joy. Wonder abounds wherever I turn. And what was once overlooked is now miraculous, like a flower gently unfolding. Curiosity takes me beyond my view of the world, letting go of judgments and expectations. I surrender my stories of how and why. I pause and I wonder, open to hear others' voices, their stories, their truths. Those voices inspire gratitude, connection, and oneness. And I give thanks for the curiosity that reveals a world of wonder, joy, and beauty in all people, experiences, and things. And this month, we affirm, I live in a world of wonder. So I want you to join me in claiming this truth about yourselves and our world. I live in a world of wonder. And now, do we have any announcements other than all of our wonderful activities that are going on at Unity on our live stream all evening? So tune in to those. And if you need to find out what's on the schedule, just go to unityofbloomington.org and all the calendar will be on there and you won't miss a thing. So that's a great way to keep connected during this time. I also want to give a little shout out. My good friend Donna Stevens made this mask for me with her own hands, and they're beautiful and kind of really cool. So thank you, Donna. We have to be grateful for everything that people contribute to us. So thank you all. So today, the word for today is love. And the affirmation is, I am a loving presence to everyone I meet. So I'm going to read the daily word for today. I am a loving presence to everyone I meet. It has been said that the world needs more love. The truth is that all the love the world could ever need is already present everywhere because God is love, and God is present everywhere. Created in God's image, I am divine love in human expression. I know that love is much more than a positive feeling. Divine love is the energy of oneness itself. As I remain centered in divine love, I know oneness in God with all people, including those who are dear to me and those I've never met. Divine love helps me see good everywhere and in everyone. I look beyond conflict and limitations and find the good that is always mine to discover. Kind of goes back to that curiosity and wonder. And from 1 John chapter 4, verse 7, beloved, let us love one another because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. So let's join in speaking this affirmation again aloud and together. I am a loving presence to everyone I meet. And now repeat that to yourself silently. Own it into your core. I am a loving presence to everyone I meet. So today we have a special day for you, and this is our Music Sunday. It usually happens the fifth Sunday of the month, whenever there is a fifth Sunday, and we like to celebrate with all the wonderful, positive music that we have and all of our wonderful artists. So I'm going to turn this over to Phyllis Wycliffe, our music leader here at Unity of Bloomington. Phyllis?
Say something now.
Okay.
All right. I'll use this one.
Okay. I'm a music person, not a tech person. That's pretty obvious. Okay. I thought that meant the mute was on. I didn't want the mute to be on. Okay. So we're looking at our lives through a different perspective, a different lens of music right now. The first verse in this first song that we're going to sing says, "We shall be known by the company we keep." And it's not just the people we are with, it's the company of our thoughts. All the things that are going on in the world, in our households, in our city right now, our thoughts matter. We shall be known by the company of our thoughts. This song is by a group called Mom Muse, by the way. Absolutely wonderful group. Their website is up there. If you like this, go to, and find more.
We shall be...
I started on the wrong note.
That's okay, go ahead.
We shall be known by the company we keep, by the ones who circle round attendees' fires. We shall be known by the ones who sow and reap the seeds of change alive from deep within the earth. It is time now. Turning, we shall learn to lead in love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. We shall be known by the company we keep, by the ones who circle round attendees' fires. We shall be known by the ones who sow and the seeds of change alive and deep within the earth. It is time now. It is time now that we thrive. It is time we lead ourselves into the world. It is time now. And what a time to be alive in this great turning we shall learn. In love, in this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love. In this great turning, we shall learn to lead in love.
And as our next two people come up to sing and get an order, this is, talks again about divine order. This song is by Sue K. Riley and Letty Hammock. It's called Divine Order. Everything that happens, no matter how bad or good it looks, is part of that divine order. That's something else I think we need to remember. I think that's a cry all of us should make. More of the divine. Less of us, more of the divine. Thank you, Reverend Lynn Carlson and Penny Fisher. Next up is one of our composers from our own congregation here, Melanie Roby, with a song that she wrote called I Believe I Am Beautiful. I'm going to let her introduce it.
I wanted to ask Archer to, I wanted to bless Lynn Thompson for giving me and inspiring this song for me. Last year, over a year ago, all in her exquisite beauty, her beautiful jewelry, clothing, just sleek appearance, I just looked at her on Sunday morning and said, "You look beautiful." And she looked back at me without even breathing and said, "You are beautiful." And that just struck me with such such an impression, and I kind of really had to go, yeah, I am. I am beautiful. So that's how this song came to be. I believe I am beautiful. I believe my light shines. I believe I am wonderful. I believe my heart loves. I believe I am prosperous. I give, I receive. I am made in the image of God. I believe, I believe. I believe you are beautiful. I believe your light shines. I believe you are wonderful. I believe your heart loves. I believe you are prosperous. You give, you receive. You are made in the image of God. I believe, I believe. Believing is trusting the promises of God and claiming them for my life. Believing is knowing I'm worthy to receive these gifts that are mine. I believe we are wonderful. I believe our hearts love. I believe we are beautiful. I believe our lights shine. I believe we are prosperous. We give, we receive. We are made in the image of God. I believe, I believe. We are made in the image of God. I believe, I believe. Do you believe you are beautiful?
Every one of us has the Christ inside, so we are beautiful, we are good, we are the Christ inside, and it comes and shows on our outside to be beautiful. Okay, I promised you in the newsletter that we are going to have a mainstream inspirational song, and I've been calling Dan Josh all week. He's going to sing You Raise Me Up, which Josh Groban actually made famous, and he's going to do a beautiful job with it. But more than you raising me up, look at the Christ inside to raise you up. The you is the you that's inside. It's also the people who live in your household, the people that you adore, the people you look up to. Anyone who has the Christ inside and whom you respect can raise you up. But more importantly, you can raise yourself up through the Christ inside.
Thank you.
When I am down and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up in time than I can be.
Thank you. And that's one of those songs I think you can say, okay, we can go home now because the sermon has been preached. And I want to thank Betsy for providing the harmony on that. Before we go into meditation here, as we raise each other up, which we have to do daily, especially in these times right now, I think we need to be reminded too that we are here for each other. We are here to help each other and walk each other home. We're going to go into meditation with a song called Walking Each Other Home that we're going to teach you. We want you to sing along with us. We're going to sing the first verse in unison together, and then we're going to ask you to join us. There are only two verses to it. We are all just walking each other home. That's the words for the first verse. The second verse is we are all just doing the best we can. So we're going to sing it through once, so that you can hear what it sounds like, ask you to sing it with us in unison a second time, then we'll sing it again with harmony, and then the second verse, and then go back to the first verse as we then go into meditation after that.
We are all
just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home.
Join us, please, on this.
We are all just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home.
First, one more time.
We are all just walking each other home. We are all just walking each other home. We are all just
center now, into your home center, and know that in that place you are one with the source of all love, life, wisdom, and abundance. Breathe and relax in to the awareness that in spirit we carry our home within us. We are all just walking each other back to ourselves. And someday, when our hearts no longer sustain our lives, we will still find our home in spirit, in the heart of God. We are known. We are known. beautiful. We are all lifted up. All is in divine order. And we are so grateful to let our Christ lights shine. Love sings through us, shines through us, and lives as us. Breathe into that for just a few sacred moments now in the silence.
Just walking in.
return now to the practice of generosity. We are grateful for the many ways that this center supports us in our spiritual growth, and we in turn are happy to support the center with our financial contributions and our voluntary service. We are also grateful to those who have already put into place their automatic weekly, monthly, or quarterly giving. And today, if you feel led to make a contribution to give, visit our website at unityofbloomington.org and click on the giving link. You can also place a check in the mail, and our mailing address is 4001 South Rogers Street in Bloomington, Indiana at 47403. 4001 South Rogers Street, Bloomington, Indiana, 47403. And I invite you to place your hands over your heart as we say our abundance affirmation. Together, I am an abundant being living in an abundant universe. God is the source of my supply. I am not dependent on people or situations for my good. God is the source of my supply. I always have something to give, and I consistently give it. I expect the best, I give my best, and I now attract the best in every experience. So let's bless our offering with these words. Together, divine love flowing through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And I'd like to invite our prayer partner this week, Ginger Curry, up to close the service.
Thank you very much, Dan. And thank you all for joining us this week for Music Sunday. And thank you all for our musicians that came and sang. And thank you, Andy, Seb, and Defta, for our tech prowess, getting us out on the interwebs. And a big thank you to Richard, who was here with me for 2 hours yesterday, debugging our bugs. And so we're very grateful that we have come together and we have expanded and we have grown and that we are thriving, because that's who we are called to be. We're called to thrive. We're called to live and love to the best of our ability. So I am available if there is something you'd like to celebrate, or if there is something that you have on your heart that you would like prayer support with, I will be happy to pray with you. So just contact me at gingercurry@gmail.com. And we're closing our service today with what we call the love prayer. And please join me in saying the love prayer. Together, we give thanks for the light that fills us and the love that enfolds us, the power that heals us, the presence that guides us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And as you go through this week, remember that you are love in expression to every experience that you have, to every individual you come in contact with. Have a blessed week, everyone. Bye-bye.